I believe that human beings have already discovered the solutions to most of our pressing problems. The challenge is that these solutions come in the shape of puzzle pieces. A research paper here, a conference report in Chinese there, a heated online discussion, an internal memo in a corporation, they are scattered. The abundance of knowledge that we have today is unprecedented, but our human minds do not have sufficient computational power to process it all. Or easier said, we can't read and understand everything. Every single day, 3,000 papers are published within science, technology, and medicine alone. 3,000, not to mention the millions that are already out there. So a lot of these resources end up in the digital equivalent of a dusty old drawer. 50% of papers published are read by less than 5 people. That's sad. But what if we had a brain? A really big, really powerful brain that could read and make sense of all of this. Well, that is what we are building with Iris AI, an artificial intelligence that will be able to read all of the world's research and help us connect the dots. So when we decided to build Iris, to get research out of the ivory towers and into the real world, we asked ourselves, what's the best place to start? Who do we start with? And the answer was obvious: the entrepreneurs and the innovators, people who do that on a regular basis. So the first version of Iris is a tool to help these entrepreneurs and innovators working in tech fields to more easily navigate this scientific world. Now, in a 5-year perspective, Iris will not only be able to help these entrepreneurs navigate the world, but also start connecting the dots. So if you're looking for a specific method of some kind for a specific problem that you have, Iris can scout all of the research in the world and help you find the right method. Or if you have, you know, you have a result that you're looking for, but you're not sure how to achieve it, Iris will be able to look for papers for you, combine different technologies, and present it as a potential solution. Now, in an even longer perspective, Iris just might be able to become a researcher herself, dig into a field, find a hypothesis, run some experiment, maybe connect her to a biotech, you know, robotics lab, and have her write research papers on the results. Why not? And the coolest thing about all this, when, you know, this brings out the geek in me, that once we've figured out how to let Iris, or once Iris has figured out how to train human beings in science, she will also be able to train other AIs. So basically, we are going to train robots in science. How awesome is that? But why hasn't this been done already? I want this tool, is a quite common thing that we hear. And the thing is, up until very recently, this has not been possible. But there are 3 things making this possible right now. The first are the recent advances in artificial intelligence technology. We see it in the media all of the time with lots of news, right? We've known about the field and we've dug into the field for a long time, but with recent advances in computational power and in access to enough data, we can actually implement it in practice. The second one is crowd intelligence. The digital connected world that we live in allows us to create a community of AI trainers across the world. And the third one is the movement towards an open society. Right? We've seen it with open source software. We're seeing it in open source hardware. We're seeing it in industries like the music industry that has been cracked open, having to find alternative business models like streaming, right? And we're seeing the same shift in academic publishing, with open access publishing. And that is a very, very good thing. So about 6 weeks ago, our baby Iris was born. We call her our baby, not just because we created her, but because she's a very young AI, and it will take her time to learn. And when we decided what to start teaching her, we decided to teach her ideas worth spreading. Iris can read TED Talk scripts and understand them. So what she does, you give her a TED Talk script, she extracts the key concepts from the script, she clusters them for context, she looks at synonyms for a broader understanding, she generalizes this across all TED Talks and presents the results back to the users and connect it to scientific papers. So I want to take you on a little bit of a metafictional roundabout, and I am going to show you the science around the talk that you are listening to right now. So I gave Iris the script for my talk before I got here, and what she told me I would be talking about was AI, unprecedented and applied, published papers, and some kind of navigation assistant. And digging into this tool, I found a lot of really interesting papers, including one about AI-based learning approaches in strategy games, which was super, super interesting for what we are doing. And this tool is live on our website, so you can go check out all of the main TED Talks if you want to dig into it. So we're a very small team with a very big vision. And we can't do this alone. We need your help. So if you want to help us train this AI, you can sign up as an AI trainer on our website. If you are a researcher, please help us by publishing your papers open access. If you have a little bit of extra money or you're part of a fund, we do propose an excellent business opportunity. Or if you simply love science as much as we do, please use Iris the next time you want to explore a topic. I think it's time to piece together the puzzle. It's time to build an artificial intelligence that will be able to read all of the research, all of the abundant knowledge that we have, and help us connect the dots. Thank you very much.